Hallelujah. Let's open our Bibles from the book of Judges, chapter number 8.
Bathudi, chapter 8.
Let's read from verse 1.
Chapter 8, verse Judges. 1.
The book of Judges.
Judges, chapter 8, verse 1.
Can we stand on our feet and let's read 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'll wish you to sit down, and then we probably will read the rest sitting down. Yes. 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 This is our scripture. Wow. Let's give the Lord a big enough praise. And let's settle down. I want us to read the following verses, verse number 5, 6, 7, whilst seated.
5, 6, and 7.
Number 5. Let's read it. Yes. Now let's read that verse again. And the leaders. Verse 7.
So you said, what is cause when the Lord has given us Zeba and Zalmunna in my hand? Then I will see you fresh with the cause of the wilderness and the wilderness.
Amen. I would not wish to relate the whole story, but I'm trusting that with a few verses that we read, God will bless us. But you'll remember that at this time, Israel was ruled by the judges. Because Israel had not been given a king yet. So Israel was ruled by the judges. You remember there were quite several of them. One of which was Samson. The other one is Gideon.
And
quite a number of them. But I want us to talk today about this man called Gideon. In chapter 6, God comes to Gideon through an angel. And he says to him, hey, you man of valor. And Gideon was amazed to be greeted by the angel of God that way. Man of valor. Why? Because Israel was in loggerheads. with the Midianites. Of course, and with Amalek. But this time around, the Midianites rose against Israel.
And
the Bible says Gideon was busy preparing some wheat on the threshing floor. So that he can hide it from the Midianites. So the Bible says the angel of the Lord, whilst he was on the threshing floor, came to Gideon and greeted him that way. Man of valor. Man of valor. Man of valor. And Gideon said to him, why would you call me like that?
Well,
I'm doing this so that we can hide to the Midianites. Now you got to understand that now when the Bible spoke to Gideon, or God spoke to Gideon as the man of valor, he was not talking to Gideon as a man necessarily of strength. Not that he was powerful. But God was talking to him as a man that had courage to face his challenges against everything. All these other Israelites, they never thought anything about the Midianites. This one was preparing food so that he can hide it from the Midianites. And God saw him as a man of valor. As a man that is ready to attack his challenges. As a man that has courage to attack his problems. There is nothing as discouraging as a person who is not ready to confront his challenges. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 With God, in one way or another, be ready to confront your challenge. Because the challenge that was never confronted, it will remain a challenge for the rest of your life. I said the challenge that was never confronted, it will remain a challenge for the rest of your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I see many people. I love people. And I see many people in Shebeens. When we ask them, why are you drinking this thing? All of them will tell you that I'm drinking because I've got a challenge. Why are you onto drugs? Why have you left your home and sleeping under the bridges because it's not nice? All of these people will tell you now, I have a challenge at home. But I have a challenge at work. I have a challenge this way and that way.
So
they left their homes to go sleep under the bridges because they have challenges.
But
I always have a message to say, a challenge not confronted will remain a challenge for the rest of your life. It's not wrong to have a challenge, but it is wrong not to confront your own challenges. Shout praise the Lord.
Amen.
When you meet a challenge in the family, don't drink beer. Because when you are sober, the challenge will still be there. Shout, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't hang yourself because of the challenge. Because the challenge that you hang yourself with, your children's children will be faced with the same challenge. So rather you face the challenge head on, so that you are safe from the challenge. Amen.
Amen.
Not only yourself, but even the generations to come. Shout, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Shout, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Shout, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Some of you, you suffering today because your parents were not ready to confront their challenges. And when they died, the challenge in the family remained waiting for those that were going to come.
And
listen to me, Church of Jesus. It is time for the Church of God to be able to stand against everything that they are faced with. Fight. Conquer. If it is not conquered, don't stop fighting until something good is happening. Because it is not going to stand there for you alone. An unconquered challenge will wait for you. To wait for your children. To wait for your children's children. Listen to me. Remember, your children are waiting to see on how you're going to overcome. If you don't overcome, it's going to be worse with your children. You know why? Because the Bible teaches me that children, they are not only a gift, but they are an arrow. By an arrow, it means that now your Jesus, if you have walked up to here, your children, they don't come anything but as an arrow.
By
them being an arrow, it means they fly higher. They run thicker, swifter in what they saw from their own parents. Didn't hear me. I said your children will always move faster to what they saw from you.
An
arrow. They are an arrow. It doesn't matter how difficult it is. Fight it until you win. So that whatever is going to be shot in your children
should
be the victory that they saw in their mothers.
Praise the Lord.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
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 Are you listening to me?
Little
are you listening to me?
Little
are you listening to me?
Little
so Gideon, God saw a man of courage to face challenges.
Now
listen to me. After God has given him all the
instructions,
he came with the many men of army. And God said, those people are too many for me. Because Israel might think They overcame Midian through their own strength. So reduce those men. I want only 300. And this is the strategy. Go to the river and let them drink water from the well. Anybody that is going to kneel and drink water by the mouth and leap from the well by his own mouth, that person is not worthy. Go to the battle. You know why? God was saying, when you're leaping with your mouth, you got to hold the ground with the two hands. And at that time, you don't have the weapon. You don't have the weapon to fight with. Because all your hands are holding the ground so that you can go down with your mouth. All the people who put their weapons down, even if it's for a good reason, they want to drink water. But if this person put the weapon down, that person is not ready. It's not worthy to go to the battle. And I got to challenge you in the name of Jesus. When you are faced with your challenge, don't put your weapon down. I said, don't put your weapon down. The word of God is your weapon. Prayer is your weapon. The Holy Ghost is your weapon. So don't put your weapon down when you are faced with the devil. When you are faced with your challenge, never put your weapon aside. I don't care how hard you are beaten by the devil, but hold on to your weapon. Tell your devil and say, I'm feeling the pain, but I will never leave the word of God. I am feeling the pain, but I will never leave prayer. I am feeling the pain, but I will never forsake church. I will never forsake prayer. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
So the Bible says, everybody that put the weapon aside, you are sent back home. Now listen to me, child of God. You will never win over the challenge by your own strength. You need the weapon that God has laid in your hands to fight the devil. And listen to me. When he has done all that, he was left with 300 people. And God said, now you can fight. You remember that these people that they were going to face were around 130,000. Somewhere around there. And with 300 people.
But 300.
Against 130 people.
130,000.
Amen.
Amen.
That was supposed to be a miracle. It is supposed to be a miracle. The victory is a miracle. Fighting 130,000 people with
300.
It's a miracle. I said it's a miracle. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And God said, now you can go and fight. Amen.
Amen.
And then Gideon give his people strategy.
Gideon afaba tuba a strategy.
I want you to note the strategy that he gave them. He says, we're going to be in three groups. Wow. Every detail in the Bible has something to tell us. Three groups. 300.
People.
And we're going to be in three groups of 100 each group. And then he said, you're going to have the pictures in your hands. And then when you have these things inside the picture, there will be a
torch
or a lamp. Wow. There shall be a lamp in the pictures. And you're going to hold trumpets. And there is the lamp inside
the picture.
And you are holding a trumpet. He says, when I blow the trumpet, I will blow the trumpet and break the pitcher, which is in my hand. And one group from each position will have to blow trumpets and break the pitchers. You got to remember that now when you break the pitcher, the pitcher falls off because it's broken. But he says, pick the light. Pick the lamp. Don't care much about the picture. The matter is in the lamp. Shout praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So just take the lamp and the trumpet. Take the lamb and the trumpet. I want the sound of the
picture
when it's broken. Let the sound be heard once. Somebody has got to listen to this. Somebody has got to listen to this. God said to one man in the Bible, and he says, go to him, because this is a vessel that I've chosen to myself. It's a vessel. Okay, so a picture can be a representation of a person, a human being, just as you are. Now listen to me. There are some times when we have to face our challenges, more especially challenges that scare us. You got to deal with yourself. You get to get yourself broken. You get to get yourself broken. Break the vessel. And let the sound of the breaking of the vessel be heard in the kingdom of darkness. Let it be heard that you are no longer yourself. Let it be heard that it is no longer you, but it is Christ that is living in you. Paul says, it is no longer I. Shout praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You got to come to an area where it is no longer you. All about you is broken. You look at the devil and say, I failed as me, but I'm coming to God to break me so that I can face you not as myself but as God within my life. Shout yeah! Now listen to me, child of God. Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. The Bible says, when the pictures were broken,
oh.
You know the devil eats up. Yeah. He eats up from the dust. How many of you know that? The devil's food is dust. The devil's food is my flesh. That's why when God cursed the devil,
he said,
from today, you will eat the dust. You will eat from the dust. Your lunch, your breakfast, your supper will be dust. And how is your body made? Out of dust. So the devil feeds out of your flesh. Hello.
Amen.
Are you listening to me? 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 Every time we are in the flesh, we are serving the devil with a nice
Refepa Satan.
Plate.
Ka plate ye botsi.
Good menu.
Chao ja tshe di botsi.
Lift up your hands and shout praise the Lord.
Emisha matsoa ga go re motimo aretwe.
Listen to me.
Tsheletse ge.
So the Bible says,
Biele le re lentshula motimo.
That was broken.
Iphatlegile.
And they hold the lamb.
Ba tshwara le bona.
It's like the whole army of Midian. When they only see only 300 lights. And they heard the noise of the flesh broken. They started killing one another. Jesus. You can't win this battle in the flesh. When you walk in the spirit, the devil will have to see on who to kill, not you. He will have to see on who to torment, not you. If he can't find anybody to torment, demons will have to torment each other. I hope you're listening. But that's not what I want to talk about. My message is in verse number 4. Now, when he crossed the Jordan, the Bible says, when he crossed over, and when he crossed over the Jordan, he found before that in verse 1 the Bible says, and the man of Ephraim said to Gideon. Now you got to listen to this.
Tell it us.
Now the man of Ephraim said to Gideon. Why have you done this? Now, they did not ask him whilst he was still fighting. They didn't ask him whilst he was still preparing the war.
They
asked this question when he had conquered over Midian. The two princes and two kings managed to escape. And he pursued them, killed the first two princes. But he was left with the two kings. Now, when this thing happened, now the Bible says, Ephraim, which is part of Israel, asked Gideon. The elders of Ephraim, they asked Gideon, Why did you leave us when you went to war? Why? Because people have a tendency of wanting to enjoy the victories of the fights they never fought. This is the nature of a person. We wish if by any chance God could take me out of this. When you never fought it. That's not how it should work. Look at how this man Gideon addresses the Ephraimites. He says to them, why do you worry over the little battle that we have won when you are even harvesting in the leftover of the grapes? In other words, because the clan of the tribe of
Ephraim
was a big tribe. This boy, Gideon, was the son of Joash. And I want to show you that they belong to a very small clan.
He says,
why you, as big as you are, you worry for the battles won by the just a small clan?
You
are enjoying all the grapes, we don't get anything. But just when we win one small battle, it's a problem. Now when he prays them to say you are great, you are doing great things, that's when they relaxed. But I like verse 4.
It
says, when Gideon came to the Jordan, he and the 300 men who were with him crossed over. Crossed over. The Bible says they crossed over. They crossed over. The battle was on the other side. But they crossed the Jordan to the other side. Because there were still 2, 3, 4 men that they were after. But they crossed over. The Bible says exhausted. Faint. Faint yet in pursuit. This is what I want to talk about in closure. Exhausted. Yet in pursuit. Because this is how a child of God should behave. Fight all the challenges. Be tired. But never stop. Fighting. Because you are tired. We have so many people who hang themselves because they are tired. Who results in drugs because they were tired. Who end up in wrong places because they were tired. Maybe you've gotten into that place where you are because you were tired. But the Bible teaches me that
Gideon
came to Jordan and he crossed over exhausted yet in pursuit. Yet running after in pursuit. Yes, running after his enemies. In pursuit. Shout praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What am I saying? This man was tired. I remember in the Bible, 1 Kings, I think chapter
19.
The Bible teaches us of a prophet that walked a journey until he was tired. And he sat under the tree. And he wished for death. Father,
bread.
Take me. Let me die. Because I'm tired. There are so many things that happen when people are tired. There are so many things that happen when people are tired. There are so many things that happen when a person is tired. When a person is tired of the things of this world, some will take lots of tablets and take them at one time. The wish to die. The wish to die. Because they are tired. I'm not just talking. I'm talking to somebody. The Lord spoke to me to come and share this message to somebody that because you are tired, it does not mean you just have to give up your life because you are tired. It does not mean that you should just hang yourself because you are tired. It does not mean that you just have to give up everything. Listen to me. Everybody that gets to be tired in battle, they've got to know that it's not when you are tired that the battle is over. It's when you keep on pursuing. Now the one thing that should encourage you is the money battles that you won. Listen to me. You may be tired of this one thing, but remember the many challenges that you conquered. And let all those things give you courage to continue. Give you courage to fight the more. Because the devil is a liar. He is a defeated foe. You shall conquer even this one that stresses you so much. You will conquer even this challenge that is so much of a stress. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. Because God is by your side. The Bible says they were tired, but they were still in pursuit. They were still wanting to fight. They were still running after their enemy. They said, "We will never rest. The only time we shall rest
is
when we have killed the two kings and their sons." Because, now listen to me, Gideon knew on how to fight. He wants to kill the kings and the sons. You know why? Because if he doesn't kill the king and his son, they will regather. You know, those that are doing pest control, they will agree with me.
Bao ba dirang pest control ba ka dumellana lenna.
But when you want to destroy the termites,
gore ge o nyaka go bolaya termites,
you don't just go about, you know, wanting to deal with every little heap of soil that you see.
Aodo kitimisha mutu wa mabuo ubona.
The termites, they've got king.
The termites dina lukhoshi.
And they've got a queen.
Ibile dina lukhoshi radi.
Termites.
The termites.
Mushwa. They've got a king.
Dina lukhoshi.
And they've got a king.
Ibile dina lukhoshi radi.
And they've got a son.
Ibile dina lukhoshi.
So when you want to destroy the termites, you should be able to identify where the king is. Because if you destroy the rest of them and leave the king, they will regather. And that thing will continue. So, Gideon, he wanted to destroy the king. So, but when he crossed the Jordan, he arrived at a place called
Succoth.
I'm concluding. Listen to what he said. He says, give me bread so that I can feed the 300 men that I'm with, because they are hungry and tired, and they can't continue anymore.
And
the leaders of Succoth said, the hands of Zeba. Zeba is one king of Midian. And Zalmunna is another king of. Are these guys at the hands of Zeba and Zalmunna now in your hand? Did you capture them?
Na matsogo a Zeba
bread for, from us.
Na matsogo a Zeba le Zalmunna a mo go wena na mo ileng gore o katla wa gopela borotho mo gore tsa o ja mo gore.
The hands of Zeba and Zalmunna in your hands. Did you capture them?
Matsogo a Zeba le Zalmunna a mo go wena mo ileng gore o ro ba tshwara na.
That you can ask bread from us.
Mo ileng gore o katla wa gopela bogobe mo gore.
You know what it means?
Let's see
what they were actually saying to Gideon. Is that go and catch
Zeba.
Go and catch Zalmunna. And when you back with them, we'll give you bread. These people, they don't have strength to go fetch.
If you don't have Zeba and Zalmunna, then I won't give you bread.
Why were they asking this bread? They wanted to get bread so that they can go catch
Zeba and Zalmunna.
So, people of Succoth deny them bread now. They promise them bread later. This is how the devil works. The devil will never give you bread now when you need it. Now listen to me. Bread is the word. It's Jesus himself actually.
He
says, I'm the bread of life. So they say, can we have the word so that we can gain strength to fight over these kings of darkness?
Well,
now they say,
they are saying now,
go fight them. Without the word, we'll give you the word when you have won.
Amen.
What is it that God is telling us?
Every
time you feel tired,
look
for the word. Every time you feel like you don't want life
anymore,
put tapes. Listen to God's word.
Read the Bible.
Listen to preachings. Every time you feel like you're tired of life, don't take a rope. Read the word. And God will uplift your spirit.
Jesus.
Lift up your hands to the Father. Father, we thank you for the ministry of your word. And we give you all the praise, Lord. We thank you. And we say there is no God like you. No, none is like you, O God. We pray that, dear Father, you help us. Bless us. Give us your word all the time so that we are able to face challenges. Some of these people are tired, O God. They fought many battles and they can't fight anymore. I pray that this word that we preach today, let it be medicine, let it be bread into their spirits so that they can stand up and fight again. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. And we thank you and call it done. Shout hallelujah.